Welcome, here is Grace. We want to present you today's topic. That is general security rules, where to start. What is WASP? The Open Web Application Security Project, or WASP, is an international nonprofit organization dedicated to web application security. One of WASP's core principles is that all of their materials be freely available and easily accessible on their website, making it possible for anyone to improve their own web application security. The materials they offer include documentation, tools, videos, and forums. Perhaps their best-known project is the WASP Top 10. Main security subjects. Web application security. Security focused on exploits often by manipulate forms or URL. Security in database. Refers to encryption system in database and in regular backups on different machines. Server security. Focuses on the protection of data and resources held on the servers. It comprises tools and techniques that help prevent intrusions, hacking, and other malicious actions. Browser security. Focus on defending from cross-site scripting, XSS, also leak in informations, and many viruses, malware, and more danger application. Email security. Focus on possible range in attachments, such as virus or fake website, and possible leak in information. Password security. That is best practice to avoid leaking password by, for example, setting long password different between each portal. What is the WASP Top 10? The OWASP Top 10 is a regularly updated report outlining security concerns for web application security, focusing on the 10 most critical risks. The report is put together by a team of security experts from all over the world. WASP refers to the top 10 as an awareness document, and they recommend that all companies incorporate the report into their processes in order to minimize and/or mitigate security risks. Example of WASP Top 10? Number 10, server-side request forgery. Is added from the top 10 community survey, number 1. The data shows a relatively low incidence rate, with above average testing coverage, along with above average ratings for exploit and impact potential. This category represents the scenario where the security community members are telling us this is important, even though it's not illustrated in the data at this time. Number 9, security logging and monitoring failures. Was previously insufficient logging and monitoring, and is added from the industry survey, number 3, moving up from number 10 previously. This category is expanded to include more types of failures, is challenging to test for, and isn't well represented in the CVE/CVSS data. However, failures in this category can directly impact visibility, incident alerting, and forensics. Number 8, software and data integrity failures. Is a new category for 2021, focusing on making assumptions related to software updates, critical data, and CI/CD pipelines without verifying integrity. One of the highest weighted impacts from common vulnerability and exposures/common vulnerability scoring system, CVE/CVSS, data mapped to the 10 CWEs in this category. Insecure deserialization from 2017 is now a part of this larger category. Number 7, identification and authentication failures. Was previously broken authentication and is sliding down from the second position, and now includes CWEs that are more related to identification failures. This category is still an integral part of the top 10, but the increased availability of standardized frameworks seems to be helping. Number 6, vulnerable and outdated components. Was previously titled using components with known vulnerabilities, and is number 2 in the top 10 community survey, but also had enough data to make the top 10 via data analysis. This category moves up from number 9 in 2017 and is a known issue that we struggle to test and assess risk. It is the only category not to have any common vulnerability and exposures, CVEs, mapped to the included CWEs, so a default exploit and impact weights of 5.0 are factored into their scores. Number 5, security misconfiguration. Moves up from number 6 in the previous edition, 90% of applications were tested for some form of misconfiguration. With more shifts into highly configurable software, it's not surprising to see this category move up. The former category for XML external entities, XXE, is now part of this category. Number 4, insecure design. Is a new category for 2021, with a focus on risks related to design flaws. If we genuinely want to move left as an industry, it calls for more use of threat modeling, secure design patterns and principles, and reference architectures. Number 3, injection. Slides down to the third position. 94% of the applications were tested for some form of injection, and the 33 CWEs mapped into this category have the second most occurrences in applications. Cross-site scripting is now part of this category in this edition. Number 2, cryptographic failures. Shifts up one position to number 2, previously known as sensitive data exposure, which was broad symptom rather than a root cause. The renewed focus here is on failures related to cryptography, which often leads to sensitive data exposure or system compromise. Number 1, broken access control. Moves up from the 5th position. 94% of applications were tested for some form of broken access control. The 34 common weakness enumerations, CWEs, mapped to broken access control had more occurrences in applications than any other category. We recommend you stick to the end and watch all our videos in the playlist. Check sources of this video in the description, where you can find more information. Leave the like, comment, and subscribe, and share it with friends that want to improve programming skills. The problem with traditional online security systems. Imagine a scenario where you don't require a password to log in to check your email, and another where you need to authenticate your credentials every few minutes using CAPTCHA codes. Without doubt, the first scenario is very pleasant from a user experience point of view, but lacks security. Conversely, the second one is extremely secure, but is very irritating from a user experience perspective, and no one would be interested in using it. This is where organizations need to learn how to balance user experience and security. The link between user experience and security has been closely studied academically and is known as HCISEC, also referred to as HCISEC or human-computer interaction and security. Security professionals should be fully aware of the fact that while they need to give utmost precedence to system security, they cannot overlook user experience. They must ascertain that only authorized users have access to the system and also make sure that users are safe in the knowledge that their information is safe online and they can continue to safely use it. For user experience designers, the question is, how do you design the security experience to fit the needs of the digital identity? Behind the identity, there is a person with the same basic needs as stated in Maslow's hierarchy of needs, security among the most critical. For security professionals, the question is, how do you enable your customer's business in an environment where the speed and comfort override the traditional understanding of security, environment where user experience overrides security? Thank you for watching, especially for all subscribers, and see you in the next video.